Master Herbalist Course, written by the Centre of Excellence, narrated by Brian Greyson. Centre of Excellence, Master Herbalist Course. Introduction. Herbal medicine has played a huge part in the natural healing process for generations. Over the years, many people discovered the powerful healing properties of herbs and the many ways in which they could be used for one's own benefit. In particular, herbs can help with treating many diseases and medical conditions, whilst also relieving many symptoms. Herbal medicine has been used by many cultures for generations. The use of herbs even dates back to the days of the Bible. This comprehensive and powerful course is dedicated to helping you to understand how herbs can be used in your life, and how you can take advantage of all sorts of natural healing options. Throughout the course, you will learn how to use hundreds of different herbs to help yourself and others heal naturally. The course covers everything from the different individual components of herbs and how they all work, as well as the many different parts of plants that are responsible for helping you get the most healing out of your body. Ayurveda, Chinese medicine, homeopathy and essential oils are all also discussed in detail too. The astonishing properties that you will learn about within this course are proof that you can certainly use herbs to your overall benefit and to also help others too. You will also learn about many additional aspects relating to flower essences, cooking herbs, and the spiritual benefits of such herbs. We have even included details on dozens of essential oils that you can use, how to make them, and also how to apply them. Module 1, A History of Herbal Medicine. People have stood by the effectiveness of herbal medicine in recent years, and it is a practice that has actually been around for a long period of time. People from many cultures have been using flowers, berries, leaves, and other items from plants for medicinal purposes for generations. It has only been in recent times that people have actually begun to explore just how amazing this practice really is. It is not fully clear as to precisely when herbal medicine was first practiced, but archaeological research has found that it dates back to around 60,000 years ago, during the Paleolithic era. Some old burial sites have unveiled materials from plant species that have been used today as herbal remedies. Some medicinal herbs were also found on the body of a mummified man who was discovered in the Italian Alps after having been frozen for nearly 5,000 years. The Sumerians created a series of clay tablets that list information on assorted herbal cures and plants. Their tablets date back by about 5,000 years in the past in Mesopotamia. Meanwhile, the Egyptians started using herbal remedies a few centuries later. The Ebers papyrus, which dates back 3,500 years ago, is a large scroll that has more than 100 pages of information on medical herbs. The treatments listed in the papyrus were primarily focused on the symptoms of particular conditions. At the time, these symptoms were believed to be the conditions themselves. They were not aware that they were simply the underlying factors that caused those ailments to develop. The practice of herbal medicine was carried on to other parts of the world through trade with other countries. However, Egypt was not the only part of the world where herbal medicine was practiced. The Ayurveda system of medicine was used in India starting about 4,000 years ago. The system focuses on herbal treatments by identifying the problem with one's body, finding a treatment, and then nourishing the body to get it back to normal. Medicinal herbs were often used, with hundreds of them being listed in the Charuta Samhita, a Sanskrit text that was written in the 6th century BC. China also practiced herbal medicine thousands of years ago, with a focus on the study of herbs found all around the country. Herbs like ephedra and hemp were particularly studied. Eventually, the ancient Greeks and Romans would start to study herbal medicines with a more logical approach in mind. That is, instead of adding herbs with prayers or rituals, the herbs were studied with logic in mind as they focused on extensive testing and review procedures to figure out the issues that patients had. This was all done with the purpose of trying to figure out what patients will respond to the best. Pliny the Elder's Natural History is one particularly essential listing of herbs from this time. Eventually, the studies of herbal medicine would spread all around the world thanks to trade, political treaties, and even the advancement of the printed word. The process of chemical analysis would soon become available in the early 19th century. increased testing procedures involving reviews on how certain phytochemicals occur within herbs and other plants helped to get the herbal medicine industry to move forward, as chemists would start making new plant compounds that they felt would be easier to use. As popular as it is, herbal medicine has been officially interpreted as a form of alternative medicine. This is according to the 1910 Flexner Report, a review that analyses different medical treatment options. While many herbal treatments are believed to help the body get through many physical issues, they are not to be interpreted as cure-alls that can resolve just any problem. Regardless of this, herbal medicine continues to be popular to this day. People are always looking for different herbal treatments that they can use, whether they come from the original herbs themselves or from pills that contain the extracts of such herbs. Studies are also being made to determine how efficient such medicines can be and if they can work for the human body. People have especially started to take a look at herbal treatments as they have become dissatisfied with traditional medications. They have become uncomfortable with the cost of medications and the assortment of harmful side effects that many of these items come with. As a result, people are looking for more herbal treatments that they know may end up being easier on their bodies. So, what is a herb? To understand how herbal medicine works, we need to first talk about how a herb works. This is a rather special type of plant material that can work wonders for when you are trying to ease various problems that may come about within your body. A herb is a type of plant that is grown with a variety of intentions in mind. It is often used as food, while some of its oils can be used for perfume. Even with these points in mind, it can also be used for medicinal purposes. Herbs have been used in medicine for generations. Herbs have been used by Ayurveda physicians in India and also by many traditional Chinese herbal medical practitioners from all corners of the world. These herbs are typically associated with things like thick and large leaves, small flowers, and in some cases the extracts that may be squeezed out or pressed from their components. Sometimes the seeds that come from these herbs can be beneficial. Most people assume that these herbs are just ideal for cooking purposes, but the truth is that they can be perfect for medical purposes as well. Much of this is thanks to a series of components in herbs called phytochemicals. These are substances within a herb that have strong effects on the body. That is, they can relieve various problems within your body. Herbs come from a variety of places all throughout nature. They often come from trees, vines, shrubs, and flowers. Some even come from fungi, algae, and other basic growths found around the world. These herbs are typically cultivated throughout the world as people search for the seeds for these herbs and then grow them in their own environments. Different herbs have originated from many places around the world, but they have moved on to many other areas through trade. The spread of information on how well these herbs can work for the body has only made them all the more popular. Today, people can use herbs to prepare all sorts of foods or to take care of an assortment of health-related needs. Some herbs
may even. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.